Thank you. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Valerie Hardy, head of secondary schools, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to the first ever graduation ceremony for Meridian High School. This truly is a memorable occasion as we are here to celebrate this amazing group of young adults, the class of 2022. I am joined here today by Meridian Valedictorian scholars and speakers, Olivia Scapa, Megan Tremblay. Also joining us today are Senior Class President Hunter Hicks, Senior Class Vice President Maeve Dodge, Senior Class Secretary Risa Borges, Senior Class Treasurer Ben Yamaj, Senior At-Large Representative Catherine Litton, Superintendent Dr. Peter Noonan, Chief Operations Officer Ms. Kristen Michael, Chief Academic Officer Mr. William Bates, School Board Chair Ms. Laura Downs, School Board Vice Chair Mr. Tate Gould, School Board Members Dr. Susan Dimmock, Dr. David Ortiz, Ms. Lori Silverman, Ms. Kathleen Tice, Director of Counseling Mr. Matt Sowers, Assistant Director of Counseling Ms. Sia Knight, Associate Principal Dave Sorensis, Senior class sponsors, Mr. Will Snyder, Assistant Principals, Mr. Peter Laub and Ms. Hillary Troubles, Athletic Director, Mr. Brian Park, School Counselors, Ms. Valerie Chesley, Mr. Zach Fisher, Mr. Brad McAdam, and Ms. Dana Queering, Choral Director, Ms. Jamie Sample, and the Chamber Singers, and band, in absence of Ms. West, who is participating in her much-anticipated Fulbright scholarship experience in France, we are joined by Mr. West and the jazz band. I would also like to acknowledge Four Falls Church City Public School building leaders seated to the right of the stage. Joining us from Jesse Thackeray Preschool, Ms. Amanda Davis, from Mount Daniel Elementary School, Mr. Tim Kasich, from Oak Street Elementary School, Mr. Paul Swanson, and from Mary Ellen Henderson Middle School, Mr. Rob Carey. Thank you for being part of this meaningful occasion. Last, and certainly not least, we would like to acknowledge a few special people who we know are here today and streaming online, our dedicated FCCPS teachers. Whether they were part of your journey at Mount Daniel or supported you through personal project here at Meridian, your teachers have been preparing you for this day. Each one of them has been a part of your journey, and they too celebrate with you today. Class of 2022, I met many of you just as you were entering your final year of eighth grade at Mary Ellen Henderson Middle School. I was a new principal, trying to figure it all out, and you were trying to figure out how to be an eighth grader. Two interesting things happening at once. In thinking about what I wanted to say to you all today, I went back to see what I shared with you during your moving up ceremony 4 years ago. Ironically, much of what I said to you as a collective class is who you still are. My words in 2018 to you were, I spoke of you using your voice to support a national movement on preventing school shootings. And sadly, that's still work you're advocating for. Your advocacy for increased vegetarian and vegan options at lunch were noted, and your adaptability and fortitude in navigating the great middle school basement flood, part one, and yes, there was a part two, during the coldest months of the year, which forced you to adjust your PE experience slightly during your eighth grade year. And your gracious spirit, as a few of you left your teachers a little banged and bruised on the basketball court in our first annual eighth grade versus staff basketball game, a tradition that continues because of you. My words to you then continue to be true. Stand beside each other, uplift each other, and most importantly, use your collective power to do good in this world. Class of 2022, I have followed your journey from Mary Ellen Henderson to now. And now as I've reacclimated with you as your secondary head of schools, I've enjoyed watching and meeting you as the people you are now. I can say that you embody everything that I'd hoped for you back in 2018. For those of you who don't know, The Wiz is an adaptation of a book and a film from The Wizard of Oz. It's a reimagining of the story told through an all-black cast. Its signature theme song is called Home. It's sung by Stephanie Mills, and I'm gonna leave you with a few of the lyrics. When I think of a home, I think of my friends smiling down on me, giving me their energy. When I think of home, I think of a peaceful world and joy all around me. When I think of home and love that we share, that can never be taken away from me. As the backdrop of the building says, this is and forever will be your home, the home of the Mustangs. It's my hope that you will come home to visit, to share your successes with us, and to cheer for your Meridian Mustangs, because we actually still have a few games that are pretty important happening on Friday. Class of 2022, my whole heart is with you as you leave home for a bit, and I look forward to seeing all the good that you will do in this world. Congratulations to all of you. I now invite Senior Class Vice President Maeve Dodge to come to the stage and welcome you on behalf of the fellow seniors.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Maeve Dodge, and I'm super excited that we're all able to be here today. It is my pleasure to welcome family, friends, teachers, administrators, and of course, my fellow graduates. Welcome to the commencement ceremony of Meridian High School's class of 2022. On behalf of our class, I'd like to thank everyone. Whether they be on stage behind me or in the audience, they've made a huge impact on the graduates sitting here today. Thank you for giving us your unconditional support. And of course, a huge thank you to our class sponsors, Mr. Snyder and Mr. George. And finally, the class of 2022. We are the first graduating class of the new Meridian High School. And although today is about making history, it's also about celebrating what the future now holds as a result of this huge accomplishment. Everything we've achieved and all the time we've put in over the last 4 years has helped us reach this moment. Everyone here, including myself, is very proud of you. I would like to congratulate all of you on this achievement and for being such a legendary class. It has certainly been a wild ride. Thank you.
To the class of 2022, parents, family members, teachers, and staff, on behalf of the school board, greetings and congratulations. My name is Laura Downs, and I'm the chair of the Falls Church City School Board. One of the great privileges we have as school board members is that we have front row seats to witness and take pride in the incredible accomplishments of our students. Whether it is sports teams making it to the state tournaments, successes of the robotics and scholastic bowl teams, the highest district assessments for band and chorus, 9 CAPI nominations for theater, a record-breaking number of IB diploma candidates, or students advocating for common sense gun laws and marching in the streets in support of racial equity and justice. We have the honor of seeing it all up close, and we take such pride in your achievements. If your time in high school during a pandemic taught you anything, it taught you the importance of resilience, the importance of pushing on even during the toughest of times. But it also taught you it's okay to ask for help, and it's okay to make mistakes, as that's often when we learn life's most important lessons. As you look around, remember these people. Your family, friends, and teachers have your back as you face new challenges and adventures ahead. If you ever feel lost, remember to follow your heart, give yourself some grace, and take the time to find your passions. Even with those accolades, what has impressed me most about the class of 2022 is the empathy you show towards others. The ability to put yourself in someone else's shoes is critical to understanding others, and it will help you make a positive impact in your school, your job, and your community. On a personal note, as a mom of a graduating senior, I know the hard work it takes to support our kids behind the scenes and help them get to the finish line. I want to thank the families for entrusting your children to us, and thank you for your partnership. Seniors, I can only call you seniors for a few more minutes. On behalf of the board, congratulations and best wishes.
Good afternoon. My name is Peter Noonan, and I'm the superintendent of schools here in the City of Falls Church, and I'm proudly standing before you to welcome you to Meridian and today's commencement exercises. I often will stand up at graduation and give a long speech, and today I decided that the best round of applause I'll get for the day is to say I've decided to forego that, and instead just say congratulations. I knew that was probably going to happen. But I do want to recognize some people today. This is an extraordinary class of students I've gotten a chance to know over the last 5 years. And it's an honor today to be able to recognize some of the scholars here at Meridian High School. We have a number of students this year, as Chair Downs indicated, that are international baccalaureate diploma candidates. In fact, it's the most candidates we've ever had in the history of our school here in Falls Church City. So would all of the international baccalaureate diploma candidates please rise for a round of applause? There's a final number there. Congratulations to all of you. That's over 70 students. Last year we had 50, which was a high water mark. So you've set quite a bar for our students here at Meridian into the future. We also have quite a number of students who have done an extraordinary job in this class maintaining their grade point average over the past 4 years. So for those of you that have above a 3.75 grade point average, would you please rise to be recognized? Thank you. And lastly, we'd like to celebrate and recognize our valedictory scholars who've earned a GPA of 4.0 or above for the last 4 years. So would our valedictory scholars please rise to be recognized? Thank you. To all of you in the senior class of 2022, it's my honor and privilege to just say congratulations to all of you and to recognize the hard work. Every one of you here, whether you got an international baccalaureate diploma, got a 4.0, a 3.75, or a 2.0, you're here. And we knew going into this that over the last 4 years, you were going to have to work hard to get to this point, and you were going to have to show some grit and show your character. And you all did, and I'm very proud of all of you. So thank you very much, and it's my privilege to turn it over now to Olivia Scappa.
Good afternoon, graduating class of 2022. I want to congratulate everyone for being here today. And despite everything these past 4 years have thrown at us, we still managed to graduate. With a class size of only about 200, I've gotten to know each and every one of you extremely well. Actually, almost a little bit too well. However, to be truthful, I wouldn't have done it with any other class. As freshmen, we survived the Hunger Games-esque hallways of the old high school building, dodging falling ceiling tiles, escaping chemical leaks, and awkwardly staring at each other as we trickled into the cafeteria at 7:45 a.m. As sophomores, our school year came to an abrupt end due to COVID. However, let's be honest, that was a much needed break for all of us. Now that we've gotten past lying to our parents about being on Schoology conferences and rushing through CAS, the extended essay, and all of econ and personal finance at the last minute, here we all are. As I composed this speech, I imagined myself as a withered old woman. Bear with me. Reflecting on what these past few years have meant to me. I believe I will remember not prom or pep rallies or homecoming, no matter how fun these events were, but the incredible resilience this class has shown. When COVID made our educations difficult and stressful, we persevered. When IB drained us physically and emotionally, we pushed on. We redefined dedication and hard work in the face of the odds stacked against us. I am beyond honored to say I'm a part of the most driven and motivated class. Sorry, alumni. Our time shared here together will not be defined by grades or likes or popularity, but by the relationships we built. We created a remarkable system of support through these difficult times to ensure that each and every one of us made it here today. That kind of thoughtfulness and sense of community is irreplaceable. So, as our time at Meridian comes to a close, and we navigate our futures, and we all become withered old people, the relationship we've made as a class will still be unforgettable. As we all face the inevitable uncertainties of our future education and careers, I'm sure I'll see you all added to the Meridian High School's Wikipedia under Notable Alumni, which is currently only inhabited by one person. However, success is not and cannot be defined by making it onto a Wikipedia page. The definition of success depends on what you make it, although I may be a little biased because I'm certain that making it here after these past 4 years is pretty successful. To conclude what I imagine was a difficult year for all of us, just for reference, I had 183 class absences, I would like to quote the words of one of Harvard's most remarkable and notable alumni, Elle Woods. As she put it, and I believe she says it best, we did it. Thank you.
Families and friends, recognizing that it is a warm day, if you would like to go inside to watch a live stream to cool down, we do have it open. The building is open, and we also do have waters available for you in the concession stand. At this time, I would like to recognize a few colleagues. This year, we honor three teachers who will be retiring at the end of this school year: Mr. Dan Coast, Mr. Tony Green, and Mr. Mark Robarge. Combined, these educators have taught, mentored, and guided students for almost 100 years. We would also like to honor our distinguished Falls Church Education Foundation Teacher of the Year, Miss Jen Jason. We recognize them for their incredible service, dedication, and commitment to these seniors and to many other Mustangs before them. I now invite Class Treasurer Ben Yamaj to come forward for the presentation of the class gift.
Good afternoon, fellow graduates, faculty, and distinguished guests. My name is Ben Yamaj, and I'm the Senior Class Treasurer. The class of 2022, the first to graduate from Meridian, would like to present the school with a gift that will benefit generations of Mustangs to come and show our appreciation for the past 4 years. Throughout the last few years of high school, our class has also been through the unimaginable. Whether it was COVID or the never-ending political and social turmoil, we watched each other persevere through a world-altering disease, endless homework, writing assignments, exams, personal crises, and doubts. These events presented themselves not only as obstacles, but as opportunities for personal growth and development. To highlight the hard work of the students in our community who proved to be exceptionally versatile despite these constant challenges, the class of 2022 will be establishing the Mind, Body, and Character Scholarship. Through this grant, one Meridian senior is selected each year for a $1,000 merit scholarship towards their pursuits in higher education. This senior would demonstrate open-mindedness, selflessness, and resilience inside and outside of the classroom. Instead of focusing solely on academics or athletics, this grant looks to recognize students who are the true embodiment of mind, body, and character. Thank you.
Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today is an exciting day. Today, you get to hear me give you a speech. Now, graduates, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Megan. And like all of you, I wouldn't be the person I am today if it weren't for my family. For me, that includes my mom, my dad, and my sister Maureen. So I'd like to thank them, along with the friends, teachers, counselors, and administrators who have helped me to get here. First off, I'd like to start by saying, congratulations, class of 2022. We've done it. The hard work has finally paid off, and we're ready to take the big step to life beyond high school. But the roads we traveled to get here were not always easy. We faced challenges that have confronted all high schoolers in every era, like navigating social circles, memorizing sine, cosine, and tangent, and dealing with facial acne. But we also dealt with some challenges that were pretty unique to our generation of high schoolers. We started our high school careers in the before times, and here we are, graduating in global pandemic, year 3. None of us expected that when we started high school 4 years ago. We did not expect to have to spend 8 hours a day isolated in our rooms, learning virtually, to see school dances and entire sports seasons canceled. Sorry, let me find my place again. We did not expect to have to spend 8 hours a day isolated in our rooms, learning virtually, to see school dances and entire sports seasons canceled, to watch classmates and teachers falling ill, or to grieve for loved ones who died from a virus that upended our entire lives. At times, I doubted whether we would ever make it to this moment, but we have, and we should be really proud. We faced unique challenges, but we met them with equally unique solutions. For example, my design teacher, Mr. George, sent home tons of materials to students to ensure that we could get the hands-on experience so critical to mastering design, even as we worked alone. Some friends of mine who were big movie buffs hosted outdoor movie nights. And at Halloween, I remember Mrs. Jason set up a contraption so she could give out candy to kids while still being 6 feet away. And when we just wanted to talk to one another, we parked our cars in a circle and sat in our trunks so we could see each other while remaining COVID safe. A lot of it was weird and not how we envisioned high school going, but we made the best of a bad situation, forging a high school experience none of us will ever forget. Our resiliency and adaptability have brought us together, and these are qualities that we will need to draw on in the future. I believe that there are two types of people in this world, those who are like an oak tree and those who are like a willow. The oak tree is stubborn. It is always fighting the wind, so it breaks. Whereas the willow bends with the wind, so it survives. We had no choice but to become willows over the course of our high school years, which is something I never thought I would say. But the fact is that resisting or fighting change will sooner or later break you. But by accepting and adapting to change, you can live on. Personally, I faced some pretty big lows during the pandemic, as I'm sure many of you did. Looking back, one moment sticks out. I was laying in my bed at like 11 p.m. on a Thursday, having accomplished absolutely nothing that day. A full day of class spent in fuzzy pajamas with nothing to show for it. And as I mindlessly binge-watching the second season of a TV show, which, by the way, I had started that morning in history class, I get a text from a longtime friend that I hadn't spoken to in a bit. It simply said, "Hey, how are you doing? How are you doing?" That text forced me to do something I hadn't done in a while, and that was think about how I was feeling. And truth be told, I wasn't fine. I was struggling with anything and everything, so I told her that. Like focusing an online class, finding the motivation to stay on top of my schoolwork, connecting with friends, getting outside and exercising. and even dealing with the death of my grandfather, who died during the pandemic and I couldn't see because of it. With the floodgates thus open, my friend and I talked for a long time that night. From that day forward, we became each other's support systems, and having someone to lean on helped me find the motivation to pay just a little bit more attention in class each day, to complete one extra assignment, and just simply go outside and get some fresh air. And, you know, even to take up baking. You know, trying new recipes and baking sweet treats was very therapeutic for me. But for some reason, it was very stressful and headache-inducing for my mom and dad. They, as it turned out, were not huge fans of listening to my physics teacher explain uniform circular motion at max volume in the background of their work calls. Not everyone took up baking, obviously. But the point is that we all found ways of dealing with the stress. For some of us, it was something simple, like picking up a daily cup of coffee from Starbucks or Dunkin'. Others did something a little more time-consuming, like adopting a new workout routine, doing yard work, or taking up photography. Congrats to those of you in that last category, because you basically took up a whole career path just for fun. Regardless of how we got through the day, the pandemic helped us see the importance of the small things. It helped us see the value of reaching out. So, as we continue our journey, let's embrace our resiliency and adaptability and always remember to ask one another, hey, how are you doing?
Welcome and good afternoon, fellow graduates, faculty, and distinguished guests. My name is Raisa, and I am the class secretary. Today, I have the wonderful honor of presenting this year's commencement speaker, our lovely art teacher of many years, Mr. Robarge. Mr. Robarge has dedicated many years of his life to helping Meridian grow and has been an excellent teacher, mentor, and inspiration to all of us over the years. He's been a significant part of our community for decades. You might know Mr. Barge as an art or photography teacher. However, this only touches the surface on who he is and his impact he has in our little city and community. As you walk through our city, you may find he's all around us. Though many of you may not know, he has left bits and pieces of his magical art lighting up every corner of our city. In every art student he has taught, he has left a bit of his guidance. Whether they know it or not, traces of his wisdom are forever ingrained in their art and them. But the greatest gift a teacher can give and bestow a student is not just their wisdom, but their kindness and compassion. Mr. Barge has handed out kindness freely and in its abundance. And in the end, this is something students will remember forever and how his kindness has touched their hearts and inspire them to pass this happiness and this compassion and kindness to all others as they move on through their art career or just a career in general. If I could give Mr. Barge a million flowers, I would, but for now, I can only offer a bouquet of flowers and a lifetime of happiness for someone who has given everyone so much of it with so much selflessness.
Greetings to my esteemed colleagues, the graduating class of 2022, parents, family, friends, and guests. It's an honor and pleasure to be your commencement speaker. It's especially meaningful to me as I'm retiring. It's taken you 12 years to graduate it, but it's taken me 24. And that's how long I've taught in Falls Church City. And I'm proud to be a faculty member of your class, the class of 2022. Hunter told me I was chosen to speak because the SCA felt like I could relate to the entire student body. I took that to heart and sat down with a diverse sampling of the class of 2022 to dialogue. For me, the art of dialogue is a skill we must actively keep alive, lest we fall victim to our own silos. To that end, I met with seniors who I've taught and some that I have not about their experiences at Meridian. I thank all of you that I talked to for your insightful and delightful conversations. I came up with prompt words based on Meridian and asked the students to interpret them. These conversations shed light on different facets of our jewel of a school. I've collaged them together to give voice to what I will call Stang Stories. M for memories. Spirit Week, football games, pep rallies, playing sports, championship teams, the call of Roll Stangs. Hanging out with friends in a favorite spot, the makeout corner of the old building. Along those lines, the breakup letter from the colonies to the British that Miss Mahoney read in history class. Going to your favorite class with your favorite teacher. Making clocks with Mr. George. Personal projects in the 10th grade and the sophomorphing trip, sometimes with ultra-competitive teacher chaperones. The smell of the old building, locker rooms, painted ceiling tiles, a raccoon in the ceiling of the old building in the library, geese both there and here, the postings of Mustang snores. Everyone was grateful for being in person this year. E, for empathy. We've talked about that up here on this stage previously, but two students described empathy as a core value everyone should have, and this was made clear during the last 3 years. Seeing teachers and students at home during online instruction with family and pets, instruction was made intimate through the camera, and we had a window into each other's world. Many of you appreciated teachers who gave you multiple opportunities to complete assignments and understood that your home life and your mental state is as important as academics. It was helpful to have adults in your life who believed in you. At the beginning of COVID in the spring and summer of 2019, life slowed down and many of you became, shall we say, a little less academic. Priorities shifted. You spent time with your family and small pods of friends. Some have made it a point to remember this, carving out time to keep in touch with your family even as you became more independent and busier during the past year. We are all reminded that being there for someone builds relationships and community, and at times, we all need somebody to lean on. R, resilience. We've heard that word before, and you guys had to demonstrate that repeatedly. No doubt, getting through the pandemic was tough emotionally and academically. Online presented its own challenges. So many distractions, home life, pets, food, parents, gaming, the couch, the bed. Mustang snores could be heard loud and clear. It was hard to focus. It took tenacity to ride out the emotional roller coaster. Many of you expressed feeling stronger now, though, and are grateful for the support that you received here at school, including resources for mental health and counseling for the difficulties you faced. A growth mindset helped you frame challenges, and techniques to recharge your batteries helped you find strength. We all realized it's okay to take a moment for yourself when you need one and recoup. There were some other social, personal, and academic challenges you handled. Some transferred from different schools or worked jobs outside of school. Some watched younger siblings while you did your homework. Some experienced failing a test, not making a sports team, social rejection, but you kept going. One student summed it up with this optimistic statement: use time wisely. Time is not something you get back. If you can work through the bad times, it will get better. That's resilience. I, for identity. Everyone agreed that much changed from freshman to senior year in terms of who you are as a person. You learned about yourself and your place in the world from books you read in Lang and Lit, a history lesson, a visual or performing arts class, or a club. You recognize these lessons impacted you, how you see yourself, and how you find your place in the world. You spoke of taking a class and realizing it could be a possible career or a lifetime vocation. Many realize that the group you hang with affects your identity. Some changed your group as you yourself changed. Others found a home base that anchored you through your time here. Some welcomed the accountability that comes with being part of a group. For example, being part of a club, team, choir, theater, costumes, gardening, or robotics, working together as a group towards a goal or a performance. Being part of something larger than yourself is often rewarding and gives you a sense of purpose. Whenever I've been a part of a group that's done something for someone else, like working together for making meals for the homeless, I always feel like I received as much as I gave. D for dreams. Many of you have acknowledged that you're accomplishing one of your dreams today. All of you are victorious in graduating. Some of you have very tangible dreams, such as getting a good job, making your parents proud, or buying mom a beach house one day. Other dreams are fluid. As one of you said, it's good to have goals, but you don't need to feel pressure to have it all figured out. Be present. Many of you are excited for what is ahead, and some of you feel a bit nervous. Perhaps you can take solace in the advice of one of your peers. Find a place to be comfortable within yourself and be known. I, inclusion. Finding a place to be comfortable and belong is a basic human need. During our conversations, it became evident that for some of our students, this is a challenge. Some of our Black, Brown, and AAPI students spoke of keeping both sides of their identity alive. They simultaneously took on the mantle of representing themselves and their race and ethnicity in the best way possible. A few students summed it up this way. It was a challenge to set a good example, and there's pressure to be your best self at all times. It's not fair, but it's the truth of my situation. Another student spoke about how their evolution of discovering queerness, and they regularly asked themselves, how am I going to affect the people around me, and is that going to be a positive effect? I commend all of you for your staying power. Your stories are an integral part of our story. Many of you acknowledge that a diverse student body brings new perspectives and adds to our community. A quiet, reserved senior had this powerful observation. Listening to different perspectives from peers or in a lesson is so important. Learning to be open-minded and considering other points of view is one of the greatest lessons we learned at Meridian. A. Aha moment. James Joyce called it an epiphany, a moment when you say, aha, I've got it. It's a moment we teachers live for, and it's one that always delights our students. A number of you said that as you finished up exams and schoolwork, you suddenly realized this is what you had been working for the past 12 years. You realized that school has been a training ground for life and lifelong learning, and you've made it. Congratulations. And now for the last letter, N. Neurodiversity. From what I learned, neurodiversity is the idea that people experience, learn, and interact with the world in different ways, as opposed to the idea that there's a normal benchmark from which variations are considered a deviation. We're a school system that embraces a wide range of learners. One of you said, everybody processes and learns differently, and it's important to know that about people and respect that as you relate to them. Many of you expressed gratitude for the staff and resources at Meridian that helped you to figure out which modes of learning work best for you. Some of you mentioned the stigma of being the one who is struggling in class, especially when everyone else seems to get it. It can lead to feelings of inadequacy and self-doubt. However, there was also the realization that difficulty can be instructive, that mastery of a subject takes effort, and you persisted. Many of you felt you were taught to advocate for yourself. This was empowering and will serve you well as you enter life beyond Meridian. And so now it is time to move on from Meridian. The word commencement has two meanings. One is to confer a degree, which we'll be doing momentarily. The other means to begin. So, make new memories, treat yourself and others with empathy and compassion. Know you have great inner strength and resilience. Constantly evolve your identity and open yourself to include diverse perspectives. Let your dreams guide you. Embrace the aha moments when flashes of insight light up your life, and then share the light. It's time to begin the next chapter of your story. Be present, be happy, be well. Let the adventure begin.
Thank you, Mr. Robarge. It is now my distinct pleasure to invite my colleagues, Mr. Matt Sowers, Mr. George, Mr. Snyder, Ms. Chesley, Mr. Fisher, Ms. Curran, and Mr. McAdam to the stage to join me in presenting the diplomas to the class of 2022.
Catherine Grace Litton. Hunter Allen Hicks. Risa Borges. Megan Kathleen Tremblay. Benyat Yamaj. Olivia Marie Scapa. Maeve Brannigan Dodge. Albin Abalo. Karina Rose Alanis. Amalia Erin Alexander. Hannah Beth Onico. Paula Grace Anderson. Rihanna May Arsenal. Benjamin George Atkinson. William James Atkinson. William James Ballow. Michael Christian Bartholomew. Julia Elizabeth Beal Diaz. Angie Fabiola Benitez. Garrett Alexander Benson. Jack Winston Biggs. Haley Sume Boggs. James Marshall Bowie. Nico Braverman. Alexander Brunstrom. Natalie Maria Burke. Clara Elizabeth Calhoun. Daniel O'Brien Campbell. Natalie Grace Cannon. Gilbert Arnaldo Carcamo Alvarez. Isabel Catherine Cassily. Wade Lucas Cass Stevens. Jose Giovanni Castaneda Solis. Bora Cecia. Justin Thomas Cerullo. Maya Chatterjee. Juliana Ruth Chavez. Mateo Chiapetta. Megan Brooke Clinton. Renee Christine Kopic. Philip Allen Coupard. Gwendolyn Paige Crowder Smith. Lena Emma Chaussey. Alexia Stephanie Sitari Ortega. Kieran Eric Cummings. Gwendolyn Mia Isabella Curtis Harris. Joseph Pemaraju Dakin. Gordon Scott Davig. Olivia Lena Elise DeVoe. Henry Montgomery Devinier Awad. Madeline Kennedy Deering. Jose Antonio Del Cid Hernandez. Daria Mari DeWald. Bronwyn Jane Doss. Thomas Taducci Downs. John Basra Doyle. Audrey Catherine Dubois. Charles DeRoss the Fifth. Lillian L. Ehrlich. Troy Edward Ehrlich. Yusra Dohia El Zamzami. Laylee Erna Pasova. Sarah Jane Ettinger. Graham Norse Felgar. Joshua Joseph Ferguson. Jack Zenon Flanagan. Luke William Fulgham.
Anamika Wren Galvin. Olivia Rose Games. Eleanor Claire Geyser. Luis Francisco Gomez. Fabrizio Gonzalez. Alexander Gorman Dorsey. Corey Gossain. Thomas Woods Gray. Gaspar Green. Mena Hyla Merriman. Ariana Sophia Hamid. Griffin Reed Harrison. Catherine Ann Hart. Violet Avery Chufen Hata. Kira Samantha Hartney. Noah David Heffernan. Matthew Lee Hellert. Eden Henderson. Ryan Thoen Henriksen. Greta Catherine Herman. Camilla Catherine Hill. Sophia Jacqueline Dadgar Howard. Edward Patrick Hughes Jr. Ryan Casey Ibelli. Zoraida Lucia Ikebalseta. Hedda Victoria Jaegerskog. Nason Haldin Sejas. Catherine Elizabeth Jancy. Megan Kay. Andrew Griffith Kelly. Edward Alexander Kennedy. Alexander Rhodes Klein. Amelia Isabel Koo. Mia Grace Crittenbrink. Lily Eden Kulak. Nate Thomas Cusick. Alexander Robert LaCroix. Truman Tolhurst Lapp. Yeah. Ella Madeline Levitt. Olaya June Lewis. Lauren Gail Lucero Labatum. Sydney Ruth Longer. Caswell Owen Liu. Jocelyn Lopez Murillo. Luca Lupi and Jones. Smriti Madan. Megan Claire Mann. Arena Mansurian. Rachel Rose Margarella. Camilla Massetto. Emma Claire McDonald. Patrick Michael McDonald. Jason McInerney II.
Abigail Christine Megan. David Mejia. Emerson Ashley Mellon. Lauren Abigail Mellon. Jonathan Abraham Michael. Ranveer Singh Iglani. Duncan Miller. Andrew Charles Miller. Robert Paul Miller. Annie Virginia Moore. Emil Alexander Morin. Audrey V. Morrison. Samuel Brennan Mostow. Manis Nair. Carolinda V. No. Angela Nguyen. Catherine Elizabeth Norton. Elizabeth Ruth Ann O'Neill. Fee Esther. Charlotte Berlin Olson. Jordan Othus. Sean Joseph Paula. George Haro Papadopoulos. Bella Nona Paradiso. Nicholas Anthony Dominic Parente. Ashley Penate Soria. Natalia Paredo. Dylan Charles Petrillo. Jackson Wyatt Pierce. Anastasia Pionskiva. Nicholas Robert Pratt. Robert Bladen Puentes.
Paris Nicole Renee Quaintance Thomas. Ricardo Andres Quiroz. Colleen Bradley Romps. Omar Rahman. Shaz Rajabova. William Benjamin Rambo. Hey, Will. Coral Wynn Rankin. Jackson Christopher Reitmeier. James Evans Rice the Fourth. Alexander Roberto Rios. Olivia Marie Louise Rizzetto. Ryan Juno Rocco. Yeah! Noah Argento Rodriguez. Greta Sophia Ross. Avery Ellen Ruby. Adam Maximilian Schultz. Tobias Sendurowicz. Yassine Shams. Thomas Dylan Shaw. Caroline Elizabeth Sherrard. Peter Jeffrey Schumann. Yeah.
Jake Chaconas Sisson. Troy Daniel Kane Slusher. Aaliyah Jade Smith. Aiden E. Smith. AJ Smith. Brooklyn Faith Smith. Jameson Proctor Smith. Joshua Allen Stillwagoner. Seth James Stillwagoner. Alexander James Strang. Oliver Shimon Stuffed. Maya Silla Tartolino. Catherine Eileen Teague. Heron Teddy. Anna Luisa Tepley. Nicholas Benjamin Tepley. Isaac Malachi Tewolde. Kira Walker Thies. Emma Catherine Tice Kepner. Liam John Timar Wilcox. Samuel Teron David Tombol. Anthony William Tomljanovic. Orion Funroy. Benjamin Andrew Varner. Hendrix Hunchel Veal. Alexander Tomas Vinatea. Truth Begornia Wadley. Savannah Perry Gilliam Walker. Emma Rose Ward. Paige Elodie Warren. Lewis Denham Way. Patrick Whitaker Escobar. Eli Creighton Wildman. Eva Marie Williams. Anna Ruiz Williamson. Emmett Victor Wood. Robert Isaiah Woodbury. Maria Veronica Verona. Juniper Yee. And David Kareem Ziyi.
Can you make you? Like,
I know what some of you are thinking. Uh-oh, another speech? Don't worry, folks. We'll keep this one short. 5 minutes? No, you can cut that time in half. First, let's give a thanks to all the awesome people in the audience. You guys are fun. And for all you out-of-towners, I hope you've had the chance to appreciate Falls Church's flourishing culture. Whether it's the hot and juicy crawfish, the Bowl America, or our local Econo Lodge, I bet you've made some memories you'll cherish. Now on to the class of 2022. All I can say is wow, wow, wow. We've had some fun. I hope you all remembered your tickets, because we're about to go on the memory train. Choo, choo. Does anyone remember arriving for the first day of kindergarten without power? I remember thinking, uh-oh, is it opposite day? No, but it sure started kindergarten off with a spark. Maybe others are more familiar with our time at the Big T&J. I know I had a few rounds of great teachers during those years. And who can forget our time at Colonial Jamestown in Williamsburg? I think I even saw Davy Crockett. Once we got to middle school, things sure got different. But hey, PE uniforms, band instruments, and a warm library atmosphere? Who can say no to that? Using lockers might have been a head scratcher for some of us, but once we got it figured out, we were off to the races. And did someone say field day? Nothing like free t-shirts and wet socks. But how can those trips compare to our time in the big house? That's right, high school. Whether it's the friendly staff or the variety of classes, I think we can all find something nice to say about these past few years. On the first day of freshman year, I remember walking down the hallway, decorated with eccentric ceiling tiles, and thinking, yeah, this place will do just fine. Whether it was getting a lecture in biology, finding a cozy place to study, or just chillaxing with my pals, our old school is ready to accommodate. And even after some technical difficulties, cough, cough, COVID, I can't imagine anyone's jaw not dropping after they saw our new school. I mean, come on, guys, check that puppy out. Sally the Mustang really said, I'm ready for a supersize. But I think it's fair to say we all received a supersize from all those mango smoothies from the Mustang mug. Oh yeah, I saw you sneaking in those sips of sugary fun. I can't think of a better group to share my laughter, tears, and passion with. I sure am one lucky duck. Quack, quack. I'm drooling with anticipation to see what we all do next. But for now, it's time to party. Let's all give a big hip, hip hooray to surviving high school. Yeah. In all seriousness, thanks to all of you for making these past 13 years such a blast. And after 4 seasons of managing lacrosse, and being the official horn blower for field hockey, want to give one final horn blow. And congratulations to the class of 2022.
is one tough act to follow. Thanks, Hunter. Okay, so as I was preparing my remarks to confer this graduating class of 2022, I did what any good student would do. I Googled it. I started by Googling Meridian High School graduation, and that was way too specific, you know, with the new name and all. But then I tried best graduation speeches of all time, and voila, there it was. I found 19 valuable pieces of advice from some of the best graduation speeches of all time. Don't worry, I'm not sharing all 19, but I would like to highlight a few. The first was from late-night talk show host Stephen Colbert. He said, "Life is an improvisation. You have no idea what's going to happen next, and you are mostly just making things up as you go along." I mean, come on. Could any statement better sum up our last 2 years? We could all work at the improv at this point. He explained, whatever your dream is right now, if you don't achieve it, you haven't failed, and you're not some loser. But just as importantly, and this is the part I may not get right, and you may not listen to, if you do not get your dream, you are not a, if you do get your dream, you are not a winner. His point, which was an excellent one, was that you have no idea what's going to happen next, and you are mostly just making things up. You cannot win your life. Words to remember as you will pursue your own dreams. Some dreams will be realized while others will fall short. Neither of these should or will define you, and always remember to enjoy the ride. The next great piece of advice came from legendary director Steven Spielberg. He said, "Your job is to create a world that lasts forever. This world is full of monsters, and it's the next generation's job to vanquish them." He went on to say, these monsters manifest themselves as racism, homophobia, and ethnic class, political and religious hatred, noting that there is no difference between them. It's all just one big hate. Spielberg said that hate is born of an us versus them mentality, and thinking instead about people as the we requires replacing fear with curiosity. Us and them will find the we by connecting with each other and by believing that we're members of the same tribe and by feeling empathy for every soul. I felt especially certain that his advice was meant for this special group of graduates, a group that has often leapt at the opportunity to join in any fight that would contribute to a world that would last forever. It could be forward thinking about sustainable living, a walkout against racism, or a walkout in support of making change to stop school shootings. I have extreme confidence that you will continue to work to find the we. The last quote, I promise, that I will share is from author George Saunders. He said, "Err in the direction of kindness." He stressed the importance of kindness by saying this, "What I regret most in my life are failures of kindness. Those moments when another human being was there in front of me suffering, and I responded sensibly, reservedly, mildly." He went on to say, "But kindness is hard. It's not necessarily our default. It comes with age. It might be a simple matter of attrition. As we get older, we come to see how useless it is to be selfish, how illogical, really." His challenge, don't wait, speed it along, he urged, start right now. Do all the other things, the ambitious things, travel, get rich, get famous, innovate, lead, fall in love, make and lose fortunes. But as you do, to the extent that you can, err in the direction of kindness. There will inevitably be many things that are outside of your control that will happen in your lives. But how you react, while not easy, will always be decided by you. I urge you to always remember to err in the direction of kindness. So now that I've given you all of the sage advice you can handle from some of the greatest minds in the world, I'd like to share a couple of thoughts of my own. We have improvised, we have worked to make the world a better place, and we have acted with kindness. While cliche to even say this anymore, your class has been forced to demonstrate a level of resiliency that no other graduating class has even had to consider. Let me take you in my time machine all the way back to 2018. Your freshman year, you walk through the doors of the old building ready for anything, and boy, did you get it. Your next 4 years were anything but normal. In the middle of your sophomore year, you left the old building and you never returned. You became all too familiar with the big blue button in virtual learning. While being able to turn off your camera and catch a nap during TOK was a nice perk, it just wasn't the same as being there. The next time you were taught in person was almost a whole year later, and this time there were learning hubs. Pep rallies and dances were now being held outside. You were back, but it was anything but normal. Finally, you made it to your senior year. You had to wear a mask, but classes were in person. The prom had a roof, and sports were on the courts and fields. And finally, here we are. We arrived at the end point you had envisioned when you first walked through those doors 4 years ago. While there were certainly more curves and bumps along this road than any of us could have envisioned, we came out on the other side. And in a few short seconds, you will all officially be a graduate of Meridian High School. I ask you to remember that none of you got here alone. You did an endless amount of work. You sacrificed, you persevered, you earned this degree. Your families are with you, your friends are with you, a piece of your educators are with you. You get to take all of these pieces with you into your future and use them in the ways that you need. You will always be remembered. You will be remembered for what you shared with us. You will be remembered for what you taught us. You've left your mark on this school in truly important ways. I wish the best for all of you. Believe in yourselves. Remember to improvise, work hard, and be kind. Make the best of this one life in all the ways that you can. On behalf of the faculty of Meridian High School, the office of the superintendent in the Falls Church City School Board, and with the power vested in me by the Department of Education upon the Commonwealth of Virginia, I hereby confer upon you these diplomas in recognition of your fulfillment of the requirements for high school graduation. Ms. Downs, Dr. Gould, Dr. Noonan, Mr. Bates, Ms. Michael, Ms. Hardy, faculty of Meridian High School, parents, relatives, and guests, I now present to you the Meridian High School graduating class of 2022.
Thank you.